Hi, I'm Dr. Timothy Phillips. I'm the clarinet professor at Troy University in Troy, Alabama. And in this video, I'll be showing you how to take your clarinet apart, how to put it in the case, and then we'll go over how to oil your keys. So let's say that you've had a rehearsal, you've been practicing, and you have your clarinet and you want to put it away. The first thing I would do is I would take the ligature off, and then I would take the reed off. And usually what I do with the reed is I wipe it on the back of my hands just to get any excess moisture off of the reed. And then I would put it in my reed case with the flat side down and then close the reed case. The next thing I would do is take off the mouthpiece. And usually I just shake the mouthpiece out. I don't swab my mouthpiece every time. I do maybe once every couple of weeks. And when I do it from the bottom, but I have to make sure that the swab isn't gonna hurt anything on the tip or the rails of the mouthpiece. So I'll just pull the swab through very gently and then I'll put the swab back in my case. The next thing that I would recommend for you to do is for you to pull the swab through the bottom of the clarinet to the top, because when you think of the condensation in the clarinet, it really starts out toward the mouthpiece and it works its way down. So we're gonna try to pull the moisture out of the clarinet rather than pulling it through the clarinet. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna put the swab in the bottom and I'm gonna pull out the top. You might wanna do that a couple of times just to make sure that you get all of the moisture out of the clarinet. And then I will take off the parts of the clarinet. I'm gonna take off the barrel first. And what I do in this case is I look in the sockets, like right here and right here, to see if there's any excess moisture. And then I clean it off with my swab. Okay, and then I put my barrel back in the case. And then I take off the upper joint, and there's really never a problem with excess moisture here because there are no sockets like that. But I still would wipe off on these areas, and I would put that back in the case. And then take the lower joint, and I would clean the moisture out of here in this socket and maybe whatever's there on the bottom. And then I would do the same thing with the bell, just cleaning out in all the places where there could be condensation, okay? So that's pretty much how you put your clarinet away, and I would put it back in the case. Now, the next thing I wanna talk about is oiling the clarinet. I oil my clarinet keys maybe once a month, once every couple of months. It just depends on how your clarinet's feeling. But basically, you can buy some key oil online, and I like it when it's in this little kind of thing where you can, you can aim the oil, and, in the various places on the clarinet. So I have this, and you find the parts like where the keys kind of come together. So if I'm looking on this upper joint, like on either side of this A flat G sharp key, there's a little place, and I can just squirt just a little bit of oil in those places and then kind of work it in there like this. And you can do it right here between the either side of the A key, and then you can work it in like that. And there are so many different places you'll see when you look through your clarinet, like all the different places where there's like a little divide where one key connects with another key. And when after I put the key oil on there, I always kind of push the keys down a little bit just to work it in. So it's important to do that, because what happens if you don't use key oil is over time, it's very possible that parts of the keys will rub up against each other, and that friction will create some wear on the keys. So I have seen clarinets where this particular one that connects down here has not been oiled very much. And as a result, this is very loose. And what happens is, if that's loose, then this pad may not be exactly going down and covering the hole like it's supposed to. And this is just generally something you can avoid over time by using key oil, every so often. And it's something a lot of people don't do, and you should do it because it'll be better for the long life of your clarinet. So I hope this was helpful.